This is the CAPS DBE November 2022, paper one, grade 12 exam, starting with question six. This is the financial maths question. So 12,000 was invested in a fund, 12,000 rand was invested in a fund. That was paid at interest M percent per annum. 12,000 rand is our principal amount, initial amount that was invested, M percent, so we don't know the percentage, per annum, compounded quarterly. After 24 months, the value of the investment was 13,459, so our A was 13,459 after 24 months of time. This is a compound interest problem. So just have a compound interest formula. Our end amount, our accrued amount, is our principal amount times by 1 plus our interest over our compounding periods, times the number of years, times their compounding period. So this ends up being months. So we can start filling things in. Our A, it wants the value of M. So our unknown is not this M. Our M in this case is our M percent, which is actually our I. So our I is going to be the M percent that we need. It wants just this M. Oh, A is 13,459. That was the end amount after 12 months. The principal amount was the 12,000. We sub in on our values. We don't know our M percent. It's compounded quarterly, so compounding periods is 4. And then we had how many months? We had 24 months, which is 2 years. So 2 years compounded quarterly. So compounding periods is 4. And we have 2 years. So this ends up being 8 into the calculator. So all it's a matter of doing now is a little bit of simple algebra to isolate M. Backwards BODMAS, first thing we do is any addition or subtraction that isn't, not outside this term. So the next thing is divide or multiply. So we divide by 12,000 on both sides. So 13 divided by 12,000, that cancels that out. Then we have to get rid of the order. We have to get rid of the 8 here. So we take the 8th root of both sides. That would cancel that out. Take the 8th root of both sides. So we have 8th root there. What's left over, these brackets can now go bye-bye. So again, disappear. We have a 1 plus, so minus 1 on both sides. Minus 1. So obviously, this sort of thing that you can do on a computer, you can't do nicely in the exam. I have these abilities here. So minus 1, that gets rid of that. And lastly, this whole thing, that must be times by 4. That gets us N percent. So just one more step, just remember that it's N percent. We actually want M on its own. So put this in your calculator exactly as you see it. Exactly as you see it. And M percent for me comes to 0.57784 and so on. Last step is we want a percentage. So this is M percent. So we can just times both sides by 100. Times both sides by 100. On the calculator, it would just be ons times 100. And M is equal to 5.78%. 5.78% to 2 decimal places. This is to 2 decimal places. Just a little correction here. It should be 0.05. There's 2 decimal places there, but the end answer is correct. That concludes question 6.1. Number 6.2, on the 31st of January 2022, Tino deposited 1,000 Rand into an account that paid 7.5% per annum compounded monthly. He continued to deposit 1,000 Rand every last day of the month. So the 31st of Jan is already the last day. So it's just going to be the last day of every month. He'll make the last deposit on the 31st of December. So last deposit, 31st of December 22. The first deposit is the 31st of Jan 22. Will Tino have sufficient funds in the account on the 1st of January 2023? So this 31st of Jan just comes straight after this. 1st of Jan comes straight after that. So that's all normal. If I count January, February, March, all the way through, including the last day of January and the last day of December, that's 12 months. That's 12 months altogether. The computer costs 13,000, so he needs 13,000 Rand by the 1st of January. So he needs at least 13,000 Rand. Okay. This is a future value question. He's making monthly deposits and he will have some amount of money in the future. So we start off with our future value formula, which is on the formula sheet. Our X is our monthly deposits. We have 1 plus our interest over whatever compounding periods we have. This is the N in number of years times the compounding periods, minus 1. And this is over, again, the interest as a percentage over our compounding periods. We'll sub in everything we know from the question. So our future value is our X is our monthly installment. It's 1,000 Rand. Then we have our interest as a percentage. Our interest was 7.5%. So that'll be 0.075. Our interest as a decimal, the compounding periods is compounded monthly, so it's every month. So there's going to be 12 months compounded monthly. And then it's just 1 year times 12 months. So it's just 12 months here, minus 1. All of this over, again, our interest. Write the same as there. Okay. Let's see what this comes to in the calculator. Our future value comes to 12,421.215, etc., which is for money, we definitely need to round to two decimal points. So it's 12,421.22. Rand is the amount that he saves by January 1st. This is less than the 13,000 Rand that we needed. Therefore, we can deduce that it's not enough. Not enough money. Number 6.3, Tabo plans to buy a car that costs 250,000. He will pay a deposit of 15% and take out a loan for the balance of the money. The interest on the loan is 13% compounded monthly. So let's take out a loan. Interest will be 13% per annum compounded monthly. Calculate the value of the loan. So the loan is the money after he's paid his deposit of 15%. So we need 15% of 250,000, which is 15% times 250,000. You can put this straight into your calculator with a percent sign, or you can use 15 over 100 times 250,000. Both work. So the loan amount, just quickly check this. Okay, this comes to 37,500. So that's 15%, but we need that 15% minus to find out what our loan is. So the loan amount is going to be our original amount minus the 15%. Original amount minus the 15%. And he needs a loan. Checking on the calculator, he needs a loan for 212,500 rand. He needs a loan for this amount. The first repayment was made 6 months after the loan has been granted. So this is a delay start. It's got a delay start question, 6 months. The loan will be repaid after a period of 6 years. So the loan will have to be repaid after 6 years. After it has been granted, and it wants to know the monthly installments, which is X. Monthly installments is X. Okay, so this is a present value question. Present value is anything to do with loans. Present value, you have the money straight away. You get the money right now. So you get it right now in the present, and then you have to pay it back. Present value questions. Taking a look at the way that this is worded, the 6 months after means that the first repayment we paid 6 months after, so those first 5 months is the delay amount. So let's deal with the delay first. To deal with the delay, it's basically the compound interest. So you have our end amount. We need our loan amount. So our loan amount was this 212,500 minus the 15%. 212,500 is gonna be sitting there. It's no payments will be made, so you keep adding interest to the amount even though no payments have been made. It's just compound interest. 1 plus. We had a 13% as a decimal, 0.13, compounded monthly. 12 months in the year, for 5 months only. I'll put this into the calculator. Comes to 224,262,5254. That's everything that is on my calculator, but I would store this where I would keep this stored in the calculator to carry on the question. So the question asks, what is the monthly installments? So we want to know what X is, and we know that we're working with present value because it's loans. So our present value formula, so we can just quickly grab that off the formula sheet. But we already have our present value amount. Our present value amount is this start, our delayed start with all its interest that's been added to it. So our PV, our present value, is this full amount. I just got 4 decimal places here. It's equal to our unknown X. Now we're doing present value, so the other formula, 1 plus 0.13 over 12. That's our interest taken care of. And when I do these in the exams, I like to first, just to make sure, so this is to minus n times n. But here, we had 12 months, so that takes care of how our compounding period. So we have, it's compounded monthly. But it was 6 years. It was 6 years altogether. So times by 6 years. But we've already used up 5 of those months in our delayed start. So all of this comes to, this will be added together. You do this before, but I like to write it out exactly like this. Just from looking at the formula, you have it over your interest as a decimal over the compounding period, so it's 12. So a quick rearrangement of this using algebra, we can get x on its own. For me, first thing, obviously doing backwards BOD mass, first thing we need to get rid of is the 0.13 over 12. So we have 224262.5245. And we want to times both sides by 0.13 over 12. Times both sides by 0.13 over 12. This side will cancel out. This side, it's on there still. And then we just need this x on its own. So we can really just divide the both sides by this whole thing. Divide both sides by the whole thing. And 12 times 6 minus 5 comes to 67. 12 times 6 is, wait, let me check. 12 is 72, yes. 67. There's negative 67 over there. So we have 1 minus 1 plus 0.13 over 12 to the power of negative 67. I like to just keep that in a bracket as well. This is what our x is going to be. Or just use the calculator quickly. This comes to 4724.962623 and so on. So we can say that our x is equal to 4,724. 0.96 and 96 cents. These are our monthly installments. So just check that we answered the question correctly. Calculate the monthly installment. So that's our monthly installment. That concludes question 6. Please like if you like my videos and subscribe.